probably get better. Looking at the absence list, I see that you were out of school all last week and that you have missed Mr. Abrams' class 3 times this week. Besides that, you've been tardy numerous times to his class. You understand, Sarah, that even if you're absent from only one class, with no excuse, you're truant. And the consequences of truancy can be suspension, unless you can give me a good reason why you shouldn't be suspended. Exactly what's going to happen?
Well, I'm not doing well in Mr. Abrams' class.
Well, that's no reason not to go, is it? It seems to me if you're not doing well, you'd make sure you got there.
What, do you mean that you're going to suspend me for missing Mr. Abrams' class?
Unless you can give me some logical reason for being out of his class, yes, I am.
Mrs. Winslow, I've tried to do well in this class. It just happens to be the worst subject that I take. And I've asked him to help me, but he doesn't seem to care. He's just written me off as a problem. The first week I was there, he just sort of wrote me off. If I'm a little late, he sends me to the office. And that's the way he deals with me. I'm just a problem. He could care less.
Well, are you a problem?
Well, I mean, would you care about a problem? That's the only way you relate to me, is if I'm a problem.
Sarah, it seems to me that if you are not doing well in class, that the thing to do is to attend class and prepare yourself, and you're not doing that. That seems like very childish behavior.
No, I'm not being childish. I've tried. I'm just lost interest in the class. I don't know what to do. He doesn't seem to care whether... it treats me like a dumbbell.
Sarah, I hear that sort of excuse all day long. It's not good enough.
Well, what am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do?
Accept your own responsibility. I don't believe you're doing that.
I am accepting my responsibility.
I don't believe that, Sarah. I'm going to suspend you. Take this into the outer office, fill it out, take it home, and have your parents sign it.
Mrs. Winslow.
I'll call your parents and arrange a conference with them. Here, take it.
That's it, huh?
That's it.
Martin? Hi. Can I talk to you for a few minutes?
Sure. Sit down.
I just got suspended from school. And Mrs. Winslow said she's going to call my parents when they get home. I tried to talk her out of it, you know. But she's got her mind made up, and I thought maybe if you could talk to her.
Well, I don't think there's anything I could do to persuade her to change her mind. If a thing like that's been done, it's already done.
I don't know. I just had the feeling that maybe you were the one, you know, that could talk to her.
Well, sit down a minute and tell me what's happened.
Please. I've been missing Mr. Abrams' class, you know, quite a bit, too much. Mm-hmm. And the rules are that you're truant and then you get suspended. Well, I didn't realize that, and my parents are going to be involved, and they think I've been going to school, and I don't want them to find out any different, you know? Mm-hmm.
You've missed this class a lot, too. I've had 5 absences in the last 2 weeks.
Well,
you want to tell me where you've been going and what you've been doing?
I haven't told anybody. I've sort of been sick.
What kind of sick, Sarah?
Well, I had an abortion. And, I had to miss some school.
Does anybody know about it?
No, nobody knows about it. I mean, I can't tell my parents that. I mean, you know, that's...
Have you been to a doctor?
Yeah, you know, everything is okay.
Well, what does that have to do with missing all these classes? Aside from missing not feeling well, yes.
Well, Mr. Abrams' class is... Mm-hmm. Well, the guy that's, the guy I used to go with that, got me pregnant, you know, he's in the class. And, I hate the class. I just thought, if
I understand, Sarah. I'm just trying to think what I could possibly do to help you.
You know, you could tell her that I'll go to that class.
You will go?
I'll go to that class before my parents will ever find out. Do you understand? This would destroy them.
All right. Maybe I can do something. I'll try. I'll go down and talk to her. I don't know what good it will do. I don't know if it'll do any good at all. It may even make things worse. I have no idea. But I'll try if you want me to.
Thanks a lot.
You're welcome. I'll talk to you later.
Okay.
Miss Winslow, I think we're really talking about something that's after the fact. And I think that one of the biggest problems now is that when her parents find out about this, there's going to be even more trouble at home.
Well, if it is a problem that's very crucial and traumatic in the girl's life, I think her parents should be made aware of it. I mean, the school simply cannot assume that sort of responsibility.
Well, I appreciate the school's position, and I appreciate your position. But I think this one time, you're going too much by the book.
If we let Sarah get away with this, we'd be setting a very dangerous precedent. We can't assume responsibility for the child's actions.
Yeah, but the crisis was solved. It's not a serious matter any longer.
I think I'm in the best position to judge that.
Well, the problem was all solved last Friday, and I can assure you that she's promised me, and I trust her, and she will go to class regularly from now on.
Unless you can give me some good reasons for all that's happening, the suspension stands. It's my position.
Well, then I'm asking you to trust me.
It's not a matter of trust. I think you realize that.
Well, I think it's a matter of trusting my judgment.
It isn't at all. I'm sure that you have very good rapport with many of your students. But unfortunately, you don't always see them in the same capacity that we see them in.
Well, I do try to see them as individuals.
You try to do that, too.